Tonight's Healthy Living Back to School also means back to sports for a lot of students. If you as a parent are concerned about concussions, there's a test your child can take now in the preseason that will help doctors measure and monitor. Mercy Health physician Edward Marceski showed us the ropes with the help of a high school soccer player.
Jenna Setters, who's a sophomore at Cincinnati Country Day, works hard to stay healthy so she can play her sport.
Playing soccer is what I love most, and I can't play my 100% if I don't have a strong body and a strong mind.
On the strong mind front, Jenna's taking a 30-minute baseline test.
A mental skills test for the brain, okay? To get a baseline level of how the brain functions with respect to memory, attention, processing speed, and your reaction time.
Through Mercy Health Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, the part you see right now measures verbal memory. The whole exercise basically records her cognitive function pre-season. That is so important to know in the event she takes a hit during gameplay that results in concussion. Jenna knows the symptoms.
You have severe headaches, sometimes minor ones, depends. Just feel dizzy, kind of out of it.
What's not as clear, though, is when, after those symptoms go away, you can return to the game. And that's where the baseline comes in. Doctors can compare the student-athlete's post-concussion test results with the preseason brain function on record.
Then we're going to use this test to help us determine when the brain has reset itself and they're ready to go again.
It means a lot to Jenna's mom.
Plans to be a doctor one day, so just want to make sure that they stay healthy.
If there were to be a concussive event and you were to come back here and the baseline told you, yes, there's an issue here, what would you as a parent make sure would happen?
Rest. No play for a while.
It would be a decision rooted in real information with the future in mind.
My future is what I'm looking forward to, so I can't have a good future if my head isn't in the game.
Thankfully, Jenna's never had a diagnosed concussion, but is taking all the right steps in the event something like that happens. Dr. Marceski says the mere force of a hit doesn't solely determine concussion. Other factors come into play, like hydration, cerebral blood flow, and the viscosity of spinal fluid at the time of a hit. And not sitting out after one could have real repercussions. If you would like your own child to have access to this kind of baseline screening or testing, talk to your physician about where to find it or find out your school's health system partner.